Hello and welcome to Music, A Bridge Over Troubled Waters, coming to you from the virtual studios of the Miami Showband Peace Center, a Truth and Reconciliation Platform project. I'm Stephen Travers and our executive producer, Eugene Reevey, will be keeping an eye on us and an ear all the way up there in White Cross, County Armagh. Today, we're delighted to welcome a wonderful duo from Derry. That's Anne and Gerry Tracey. You're very welcome.
Well, hello, and Stephen, first of all, thank you so much for this lovely opportunity for Gerry and I to come together and sing a song and share part of our experience. I think today, though, we were talking earlier, we'd like to dedicate this performance, if it's okay, to a lovely friend of ours who sadly passed away. His name is Bobby Mitchell. Bobby was one of the finest traditional singers in these parts, and we'd like to just remember him now. In this this evening, Gerry and I sang in Derry here, Waterloo Street, and we used to sing in the different pubs, the Guador, the Castle. We were quite popular at the time, and but one of the interesting things that we were recalling was that one Thursday night in the Guador bar, we were singing, and there was a good crowd in. Everybody was relaxing and chatting and having a drink. And the door opened and the army walked in and they just lined up the whole way across the bar right in front of us. So the whole place went hushed and silent. And of course we were singing a song at the time. So we decided we're going to continue with, well, we just sang on. We finished our song. We have no idea why the army were there. Nobody left, nobody moved. We finished the song and then they just walked out, but they were armed. So it felt a bit threatening at the time. They left and we continued on with the night. And as soon as they left, everybody, they erupted again and started chatting and it turned out to be a really great night. So just one of those moments that you never forget. So the song we were singing and the song that we'd like to sing for you this evening is Please Come to Boston. It's kind of a song that we love, I've always loved. And I heard Eugene Reevey saying that he knows the song and he's heard it before, mm-hmm. Heard Merle Haggard's version. So this is Please Come to Boston.
Lovely.
For everybody out there. And I'm sure everybody out there knows Derry, I'm sure a bit, and or maybe even have visited here. This is a beautiful city, as you know. So this is for everybody listening out there. Please come to Boston.
Please come to Boston in the springtime. I'm staying here with some friends and they've got lots of room. You can sell your paintings out on the sidewalk at a cafe where I hope that I'll be working soon. Please come to Boston, she said no. Won't you come on home to me? And she said, ramblin' boy, why don't you settle down? Boston ain't your kind of town. There ain't no gold and there ain't nobody like me. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee. Please come to Denver when the snow falls. We'll move up into the mountains so far we can't be found. I'll shout, I love you echoes into the canyons. And then lie awake at night till they come back around. Please come to Denver. She said, no, won't you come on home to me? And she said, ramblin' boy, why don't you settle down? Denver ain't your kind of town. There ain't no gold and there ain't nobody like me. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee. Oh, this drifter's world goes round and round. I doubt if it's ever gonna stop. But of all the dreams I've lost and found, and of all that I ain't got, I still need to cling to somebody I can sing to. Please come to LA and live forever. A California life alone is just too hard to build. I've got a house that looks out over the ocean, and the stars that fell from the sky are living upon the hill. Please come to LA, she said no. Won't you come on home to me? And she said, rambling boy, why don't you settle down? LA ain't your kind of town. There ain't no gold and there ain't nobody like me. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee.
Today, we're delighted to welcome two wonderful artists from Derry, Roy Arbuckle and Anne Tracey. Roy Arbuckle is one of Derry's finest songwriters and singers, and Anne Tracey has been described as a significant new vocal talent, gifted, warm, and deeply soulful. You're very, very welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Stephen.
You're going to sing a couple of songs for us, and can you tell me why you've chosen these songs or what they mean to you?
Okay. We thought we'd do a song called The Gentle Days. And this is a song I wrote when I was running a project called Different Drums of Ireland. The notion of that was to bring things together. We started with a youth project, young people from both communities, both sides of the border, male, female, all the crosses we could think of. We got them and they put a show together. We took that to Canada way back in 1991. We call that Different Drums because of the Henry Thoreau speak, which says, you know, we all march the beat of our own drum, that we all hear our own internal music. Essentially, to me, it was, you know, we're all individuals. But at the same time, I was reading a book by F. Scott Peck, which is also called The Different Drums. And that was about the essential human need to be in community, need to be belong to something, you know. So I thought we had the two poles there for the young people. Be yourself and be part of the community. It's a clash, you know, with peer pressure and all that stuff. But how do you be a unique individual and how do you be part of something? That was a task. So we did that. And at the end of that, I got a chance to spend a week with Kodo drummers from Japan, which was really inspirational. And that, I don't know if you know the Kodo drummers, they use these
taiko
drums, enormous big loud drums. And I said, boom, we got drums like that here, lambic drums. And I come from a Protestant Unionist community, so it was part of my heritage, I suppose. So the notion then was we got lambics and borons and brought the two together and see if something new could happen. That was essentially, and that became Different Drums of Ireland eventually. And we were a community effort all through the 90s, but then near the end of the 90s, we got picked up by television and we got picked up by Mo Mullen, who really loved what we were doing. And we kind of became the musical wing of the peace process, if you know what I mean. We ended up playing for President Clinton, Tony Blair, Mary Robinson, Mary McAleese. We did all the presidents we could find and went to the White House with a show that Phil Coulter put together, you know. So to get back to the song, this is one of the songs that I wrote while in that project. And the notion of the song is that before whatever the trouble was, whether it was, you know, what we experienced, the troubles, or maybe it was an earthquake, or maybe it was occupation, you know, colonization, whatever, there's some point where the poets and the writers look back before whatever the trouble was, before the disaster. And they write about that and they try to bring it into a modern resonance. So that idea that the time before the troubles was the gentle days, and the idea of the song was asking that we bring the gentle days back again.
That's absolutely beautiful. Beautiful song, and so well sung.
The inspiration for me, for the notion of the gentle days came from stuff I was reading. James Stevens, the story he wrote about The Legend of Two and McCarroll, and he mentions it in that type, you know. So that's where I got that kind of spark.
You're going to do another song. Why did you choose this one?
It's another one of my own songs, and it's called The Longest Night. And I was initially inspired by, you know, the winter solstice, where, you know, we're in the longest night, but the night after that is a bit, you know, the nights start to get shorter after that. And it's around the notion that even when it's, things are dark as they can be, there's a star shining somewhere. Do you know what I mean? That there's hope somewhere, and that things will change. You know, the wheel spins around, the wheel of life, and the seasons change, and the frozen ground will bloom again. So that's kind of what's behind the song.
Yeah. It's a beautiful song. And, you know, we've sung it on many occasions, Stephen, and different times, Roy. You know, I can remember singing it at christenings, funerals.
A lot of people picked it up, you know, for people who are in grief, you know, that, you know, this too will pass, that sort of thing, you know, and it has been played at funerals. And we did a project, remember the Chicken Soup and Songs for the Soul, where we sang those kind of songs and encouraged people to talk about what the songs brought up for them, you know, and this is one of the songs that, you know, really affected.
Really touched people,
And is this song from the album? You did an album together, didn't you? Songs for the Soul, didn't you?
Yeah.
I actually have that here, yeah. It's
good. Both of these songs are from it, Stephen. Both of these songs are on the CD, Songs for the Soul,
It brings music to another level, doesn't it? It's there as a healing agent, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I hope so. That would be, if it does help a few people, it's been worth doing, you know. Yeah. I mean, for a long time, Steve and I beat around playing in pubs and, you know, getting drunk and carrying on. And that was great, you know, the music just giving people a good time, you know, or playing for dancing, have a good night out, forget your troubles, you know, But then there came a point in my life where I thought I needed to try and do something more, probably trying to understand myself as well as then hoping that, you know, that personal statement becomes something that means something to other people. I can't explain it.
Well, I know that Eugene always disparages himself when it comes to the music. He loves music. I know he does.
Yeah.
But it's music with stories in them, Eugene. They're very important, aren't they?
They are. Oh, absolutely. That's what we need is more music and more lighthearted stuff rather than just the painful stories all the time. It gives it a wee break and it means something to a lot of people.
Really,
in that sense, it's very, very important, like that we go back to the musicians now and again.
It's exactly what Roy said earlier on. It's before the time of the troubles that you went back on your first song, that you were able to go back and look. Maybe we can learn from that.
Okay, well, this song then, Stephen, is by Roy Arbuckle, The Longest Night, a song of hope.
Dark, a fire glows in the frozen heart. There's a folded rose in the longest night.
in the morning. When the night comes down, we turn inside again,
and the wheel spins round. No. The wheel spins round, the seasons change, and the frozen ground will bloom again in the longest night, in the longest night.
Stars shine bright in the long.
The wheel spins round, the seasons change, and the frozen ground will bloom again in the longest night. In the longest night, star shines bright. In the long. Star shades bright in the longest
night. It's thanks for giving us hope from those songs and something to look forward to as well.
Yeah.
Great. So you keep up the good work on both of you.